What did he say?
That we've got wood ball and the roof support beams.
Least the church can do to support British wildlife.
Hole in the roof, now the size of the banker's bonus.
So, you won't be bumping your head on the way out during the rapture.
And he reckons we've got the Thames flowing through our back wall. 6 figures to fix a lot. 200 grand, maybe more.
Piddling amounts. We'll take it out of petty cash.
Yeah, I panic. This is the free church, after all. Apparently we worship a god who doesn't need money.
How much have we got?
A whopping £35.54.
We're saved!
What'd you say, Mars?
Do you fancy some Nando's?
Sorry, we're closed.
For churches, I'm never supposed to be closed.
What can we do for you?
Do for me? No, no. It's what I can do for you.
Put away the knife, sweet pea. You don't want to mess with her.
How would you like it if I messed with your sweet pea? Give me the money.
You don't want to do this.
Go easy on him, Joe.
Go easy? I'm the one the knife is shooting at.
You'll learn to respect God's creatures, especially cows. You'll also learn you can't worship money and God. Let us pray for these lessons. Shall we? Close your eyes. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts, we forgive our debtors.
Marion and I had an incident at the church.
Some scruff tried to take the week's offering.
Let me guess, he beat the crap out of him.
What? I prayed with him.
Pacifists don't beat people up, Mother.
I hardly touched him.
To do a great right, you did a little wrong.
Stop quoting Shakespeare. I was perfectly in control of myself.
Methinks the lady doth protest too much. The problem's not controlling yourself, Mother. It's controlling everyone else.
I'm not controlling.
Really? Let's see. You got me Nando's chicken, when what I really wanted was pizza.
Gluten's bad for you.
And I rest my case.
You've not been resting much at all. What are you working on?
I work for GCHQ, Mum. We're kind of like spies. And, you know, good at keeping secrets and all. I could tell then.
I'm a minister of the church, your bosses can trust me.
They know given half the chance you'd divert their entire budget to stop the war coalition.
Adam will be coming over for a few days.
That guy? We, Miss Fortune, steering in a fleet of boats. Why here?
The church is in financial trouble. He's come to help.
You should have asked me if it was okay. But then I forgot. You're not controlling.
Anand? Harry? I need a secure line. Yep. Yep. Done. Thanks. See you soon. Namaste. Jeez, Harry, give thy thoughts no tongue. Okay. All right then, Mr. Fancy Pants Reverend Herter. Boldness be my friend. Let's see what dirty little secrets this smiling and damned villain is keeping from the world. Hell is empty for all its devils be here.
I miss you, Grandad.
So, Henry says the church repairs will be in excess of £200,000.
That's a rip-off. Why do you let him push the price up?
That's right. Shoot the messenger, Jerry.
We can't raise that sort of money. We already get grants from church
house. We lose a lot of autonomy when we take those grants.
Head office can pull the plug on us like that. It's a deal with the devil. Mark my words.
So what? Is this the end of the church?
The church will survive just fine without this building.
And I thought you'd be the last person to say that. You have the most to lose.
When does this Reverend Dr. Adam Herter arrive? He's here to close us down, isn't he?
I'm not going to beat about the bush. Your church just isn't viable. And the denomination cannot support congregations like yours.
If it weren't for congregations like ours, your precious denomination wouldn't exist.
Jack is right. Come throwing your weight around like some church bully. We won't stand for it.
Well, the point is, you're not standing, are you? You're on your knees, financially. Come up with the funding and I'll go away. Who knows? You might get lucky.
I don't see why we're so dependent on finances just to do our mission.
It's a lovely sentiment, Jerry. But you're an accountant. You know how things work in the real world.
Nobody's closing this church down. This church belongs to God. And if God wants it to stay open, it will.
Well, what are you going to do?
You've been more than enough help, Adam, thank you. Kindly give us a minute.
Yeah. Yes, that's right.
What a sanctimonious prat. Lovely sentiment, Jerry. You know how things work in the real world, Jerry. You might get lucky, Jerry.
I'm not giving up. And neither are any of you. We're going to save this church together. Well, my name isn't Josephine Talent. And speaking of talents, here's what we're going to do. It's Matthew. The parable of the talents.
A rich ruler left three servants in charge of his kingdom. To the first, he gave 10 talents, the second, 5, and the third, 1. When that lord returned, the first servant said, "Look, I have made 10 more. Well done, good and faithful servant." The second said, "Look, I have made 5 more. Well done, good and faithful servant." The third servant said, "I knew you were a hard man, that you reaped where you did not sow. I placed the talent in the ground. Here, what is yours, I return to you." "You unfaithful wretch, you knew I was a hard man, that I reaped where I did not sow. Why did you not at least bank the money for the interest? Take all he has and give it to my faithful servants." And they cast him out into the outer darkness, where there was misery and gnashing of teeth.
We all have talents. I even have a talent for a name. Over the next few weeks, we are going to be putting scripture into practice. Each of us will take £10 and grow it until we reap a harvest for the Lord.
That do stuff for no reason, who make no sense through their actions. I just don't get it. Girl, I don't understand some things you do. Those things you do got me all confused. So why can't you let me know, boo? It's about time, just with the truth. Don't get your actions, things that you have. You told me you ain't got another man on the side. Well, I know that same love is blind. There's something in your mind you're trying to hide. Yeah.
Hello, darling Anand. Miss me today? I know. No? Sure, but one of the perks of being GCHQ's most brilliant computer hacker is I can work from home. Be a love and set up another secure line. Thanks, darling. Miss you. Wisely and slow. They stumble that run fast. This is not good. Oh, I hate begging for money.
You always said the church must rely on tithing, not outside funding.
This is an emergency.
Emergency, smergency.
Right, that's the Harrison Trust done.
Good.
What about the lottery?
Church rules forbid applying to the lottery fund.
Thou shalt not gamble.
This is all gambling. Oh, I've had enough for a bit.
will come to dinner tonight.
I don't want to face Adam on my own.
You're really gambling with the devil now, aren't you?
Well, don't you cook him? Cock O'Van. That's more up his street.
I don't think he wants any cocks in his van.
How do you know?
That's not something we're ever going to talk about.
Well, the chicken was nice.
So unlike the company.
So how's the fundraising going?
Jenny's organising a bake sale. The craft fair did really well. And Margaret is putting on the Pirates of Penzance.
You should come to that, Adam. You'll feel right at home with the other pirates.
Marion's filling out loads of forms, and the church bazaar should do really well this year.
Good. Putting your talent to work. So, have you considered increasing rentals for your user groups?
We don't charge rents, Adam. We're a church, not a business.
Good way to raise funds.
I don't think Jesus would be too keen on charging rent to food banks and asylum seekers.
Don't knock business. They've got some good people and they work very hard.
That's how the devil works. Get good people to do your dirty work.
Bottom line of business is always profit.
Business is also about service. The church could learn a lot from some of our corporate leaders like Mark Zuckerberg, Bill Gates, and, lover or hater, even Margaret Thatcher.
Yes, well, that's where we part ways. The church is not about success or efficiency. It's about faithful discipleship.
It's a lovely sentiment.
There's nothing sentimental about walking by faith and not by sight.
Show me your faith, and I'll show you my works.
Yes, well, you do have a tendency to show rather too much of yourself.
Are you still studying your doctorate in South American liberation theology?
Studies. Too busy becoming a successful fundraiser for Jesus.
I know some people who know some people from my banking days who could get you a visit with Gustavo Eul.
I thought he was under house arrest somewhere south of London.
Home Office is holding him in one of their country safe houses. His extradition to the US could take a couple of months. Time saved for a British student to do some research.
You do know he's innocent.
I don't judge.
Innocence didn't stop them from nailing Julian Assange.
I don't judge.
You don't choose either. Neutrality always strengthens the status quo. You can't sit on the fence in the face of injustice.
Do you want to meet him or not?
I want to meet him.
Then I'll see what I can do. Got some things to do at the office.
I'll get your coat. Lottery ticket. What's he doing with the lottery ticket?
Is it done?
I may be retired, but there's nothing wrong with my craft.
Well, let's hope so, Adam, for your sake. We can't afford any mistakes with this.
Yeah, hi, Jim. It's Harry. No. Yes, it's not. Lost my phone. Pass me on to Anand, would you? Cheers, mate. Hey, Anand, secure the line? Done? Yep. Yeah, it is bad. I think my phone's been hacked. Did you run that number plate? Okay. And what about facial recognition on the mystery woman? Oh, man.
Father Ayul, my name is Joe Talent, and I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Can you hear it? The silence.
Saying silence kind of spoils it, don't you think?
Gandhi says that in silence, the soul finds a clear path.
When the truth is replaced by silence, the silence is a lie.
Very good. A quote by Yevgeny Yevtushenko.
Now, Father Eyal, you are one of the greatest liberation theologians alive.
Great. Is that what you think of me? You come here seeking answers, but I have none for you.
I need to know why the church is failing.
Your institution is failing.
What does it mean for the church to come out of empire?
I see you have talent, Miss Talent. You'll find the answers in the silent spaces of your soul.
This is all very cloak and dagger.
Something is odiously rotten in the state of Denmark.
What are you talking about?
What did Adam have to do before going into ministry?
You've been checking up on him?
Banking. Except banking was only a cover. He worked for MI5.
So he served his country as a spook. Not unlike you.
Ah, but God gave him one face, yet he had made himself another.
Enough with your obscure Shakespeare references and tell me what you found.
Microphones. In our house.
For hell?
Really old school.
Old school?
When I eavesdrop, I hack mobiles.
Why are they listening to me? Who's listening to me?
You've angered some very powerful people.
What's Adam got to do with it?
That man hath no music in his soul. Only treasons and stratagems.
He's a womble, but he has a good heart.
Somebody's pulling the strings.
Who?
You need to be the pattern of all patience. Practice that contemplation thing you do. Silence, Mother. Lots of it.
I'm not sitting around without a fight.
Look, don't say anything, or they'll know it's me. Stop your control freak thing and let me do my job.
Jeez, who's been controlling now?
What are we up to?
We're up to 60,000. How much more of our faith and life must be monetized to succeed?
I don't want to lose this building, Mars.
My father preached from that pulpit.
I remember.
I mean, I hardly ever saw him. Bugger was too busy being pious and holy.
Pretty sure buggery wasn't his thing, darling. Not that I'm judging. He was a brilliant minister.
But lousy father. Lord, it's hard to forgive him, Marsbar. So what am I trying to save? This church? My crappy childhood? Or the memory of my granddad? Granddad raised me, you know. He shaped my life. I can't let him go.
Joe, he's not there anymore. It's just a headstone in a graveyard.
I feel him near me. I see him in my dreams.
I just did George Clooney. I care about this place too, Joe, but it's just a building. It's not the church.
Hello? Adam! What? When? But how soon? Yeah, we'll see about that. That was Adam. Church house has decided. They're closing the church down. Hello? Jerry? What? Slow down. How much? So, Jerry, slow down, please. Okay, Jerry. Meet me at the manse. I'll get Jackie. Gonna be okay.
I can't believe it. I can't believe it. I just can't believe it. £500,000. £500,000.
£500,000.
What are we going to do?
It's obvious, isn't it?
Nothing's obvious, Jackie. God, this is a dilemma. This is a dilemma.
Where did you find it?
I found it on the church vestry table. I was really surprised, so I just took it home.
What were you thinking?
I hope you're not implying I stole it.
It's okay, Jerry. No one's accusing you of anything. So,
You found the ticket, and then?
I've never ever played the lottery. I didn't know what to do. So I looked for some instructions, and it says you should go on a website. I did that, got the number, and they confirmed it.
That's very odd.
Maybe God gave us a ticket to save the church.
God doesn't do the lottery.
Miracles still do happen. If Jesus can walk on water, Jesus can give us a lottery ticket.
The church does not take gambling money. £500,000. Well, what are we going to do about it?
What are you going to do?
Campaign in Syria continues to take its toll on British lives. Today, the Foreign Minister's office said that Britain would not back down on its duty to ensure democracy in the Middle East. Opposition to the bombing and drone strikes is growing, with Stop the War Coalition announcing another march on Parliament. WikiLeaks claim to have evidence of leaked plans by GCHQ to shut down popular online anti-war blogs, such as the anonymous Poppy White, which has over 2 million hits every month. Trading has ended, with banking shares slipping on the FTSE 100 amidst concerns over the latest tax-dodging scandal facing financial houses in the city.
I'm sorry, Vicar. Says he won't see you.
Reverend.
Sorry?
Never mind. Did he say why?
Something obscure-like. Asked if you have been keeping silence.
I have had enough of wasting my time, and I will not have time wasting me.
What's that?
Something my daughter would say. It's time I took matters into my own hands.
Have you told her yet?
What? That the head of the church once had sex with a theology student and begged her not to say anything about it.
You hardly ever let me see her.
Why are you sleeping with Marion?
God, Josephine, I'm not responsible to you for my relationship.
That's right, Adam. You never take responsibility for any of your relationships. How's about taking... What about taking responsibility for leaving 6 microphones in my house?
She found those, didn't she? Bright girl. She takes after her old man.
Why are you closing the church down?
You just don't get it, do you? I have a responsibility to the whole church, Jo, and I can't have you bringing it all crashing down.
What does that mean?
You always wanted to be a photographer. Just leave. For Harry's sake, if no one else.
What am I doing that's upsetting the people you work for?
I work for the church.
We both know that's not true.
Did Harry tell you that?
What have I done?
Please, Joe. For Harry. For yourself. Walk away.
Jerry, it's Joe. No. No, Jerry. We're going to use the money. Yes. It's a miracle. Yes. Good night.
No legacy so rich as honesty.
Jeez, Harry, you scared me.
Shakespeare warns that even the devil can use scripture for his purpose.
What do you mean?
Have you told her yet?
What? That the head of the church once had sex with a theology student.
You hardly ever let me see her. Bright girl. She takes after her old man.
Harry, save it, Mum. You're controlling. And you really, really struggle to admit that sometimes you might actually make mistakes. Adam! Ugh, what were you thinking? And now, you want to take immorality to a whole new level by taking that lotto money.
Harry, have you been hacking my phone too?
No, no, you do not get to turn this round on me. It's that useless bloody institution you call church that has nothing to do with Jesus, nothing, that has destroyed this family, that has taken my mother from me. Just as it took your father and his father before him. Is it really worth it?
They'll try to give you money. Use it to manipulate you.
I know that now. The lottery ticket. It was a setup. I took the money.
You have to be like the third slave who buried his talent.
I've always had trouble with that parable.
God is nothing like a rich ruler. God does not exploit the poor to make money and then call that using your talents. That is to say, the devil using a scripture.
The devil citing scripture for his own purpose.
Yes. Shakespeare.
Shakespeare.
Empire is everywhere. Your church, my church, we are all deeply embedded. Empire today is states, markets, media, corporations, all because of an ineffective Christian witness.
What is empire, really?
It is a spirit, a complex of interrelated systems hidden. It excludes the poor. It rapes creation. Its purpose is to serve and defend the powerful. It sacrifices everything as it worships money in a gospel of consumerism.
Why are we so helpless against it?
We are far from helpless, Joe. We have enormous power, but we must choose wisely. God gave us two alternatives: the monetary system or God. We cannot have both.
The church chooses money.
Almost everybody chooses money. We have been led to believe we cannot live without it.
Surely money can be used for good.
Well, John Maynard Keynes believed that. But empire uses very powerful propaganda to colonize our consciousness, shape our values and beliefs to fit this logic.
And Christians are blind to its presence.
We become chaplains to empire. But God is gracious.
How do I come out of empire?
I cannot tell you that, Joe Talent. But learn from the third slave, who resisted empire, resisted its leader, resisted empire's logic, and resisted its tools of oppression.
And for his trouble got tossed into the outer darkness.
The price of being a true disciple of the radical Jesus. Empire gets rid of you.
Still doesn't tell me what I should do.
You'll find the answers in your silences. Here, I convinced the guard to bring these books for you. Debt by David Graver. Beating the Strong Man. Sacred Economics by Charles Eisenstein.
There's no women here.
Mea culpa. Allow these books to shape the contour of your silence.
It's your blog. You know about that. That's what's got them so riled up. They're targeting the anti-war brigade. Not just you, everyone. They're expanding the war, and you're just in the way. It's got nothing to do with the church.
It's got everything to do with the church. Not that crusty old building or my even crustier institution, but the real church.
Ecclesia.
Ecclesia. Everyone who has come out of empire. Harry, about Adam.
No worries, Mum. I spoke to him. He's full of opposites. A damned saint and an honourable villain. We've got a lot in common.
I'm really, really sorry. I was wrong not to tell you.
Can I have that in writing? Finally, the lady not protesting too much. They're going to come after you.
I'm not afraid anymore.
Good. Because, Mum, cry havoc and let slip the dogs of war. I have a plan.
You see, all I'm asking, girl, is for you to tell me what's on your mind. That's it, girl. You've been acting strange lately. Let me know what's up. That's all I want. That's all. I understand that people go through rough times, but he's rough, I know. Change people, but you change a little too much. Let me know,
girl. So you're the one jerking poor Adam's chain.
Sounds like I'm not the only one who's jerking his chain.
What do you want?
It's not what I want. It's what you want. You want a job, a family, a nice house.
Are you threatening me?
I don't make threats, Reverend Talent. I play chess.
And what's your next move? Rig the lotto again?
Oh, nobody rigged the lotto. Your church members are delusional.
My church members are brave. I took the money.
You have quite the following with your rather silly gobbledygook. What's it called? Poppy White. It's quaint.
Lovely. This government believes that any opposition to the important and frankly lucrative business of war is silly gobbledygook. We can just ignore the inconvenient collateral damage of dying women and children.
Don't lecture me on the merits of war. This month alone, my team has prevented 3 terrorist attacks. You sleep safe because of me.
Has it ever occurred to you that your war is the prime reason for these attacks?
I don't sympathise with terrorists.
You simply create the conditions for them to arise.
You're naive.
To quote my daughter, who works for you, by the way, if I prick them, do they not bleed? If we bomb them, do they not die? And if we wrong them, will they not be avenged?
Your daughter. I'll have that little twit arrested and chucked into her very own godforsaken black hole, and that's where she'll stay. Unless you stop your deeply unpatriotic attacks on this country. Then I'll have you arrested on charges of aiding and abetting a known terrorist, Father Gustave Eulieu. I'll make sure that the £500,000 paid to you from a Syrian bank account will be published with pictures of you colluding with that scum. Every newspaper and blogger this side of the Nativity Star will have a field day. You're finished. Do you hear? Finished. Or you could keep your job. Hell, I'll even give you Adam's job. Fool. Your daughter keeps hers. You keep the money, or you can give it away if you like. I don't care. All this goes away.
I think.
No, you'd better think. Very carefully. What are you going to do?
I think I'm going to tell you the parable of the talents.
What?
The parable of the talents?
I know what it is.
Do you really?
God goes away, leaves 3 servants in charge. 2 of them grow their talents, job done. The 3rd little sod, well, he loses the plot and gets booted out.
No.
The third little sod decides he doesn't want to play the game anymore. Decides to tell the Emperor to sod off, and before he gets booted out, he takes a note of their conversation. He tells a story that's been told a million times. Do you want to hear the name of that story, Felicity?
It's called The Gospel. It's a fascinating account of all kinds of people who refuse to be pawns in a rigged Game of Thrones. It's a story that can be told again. Right now, I wonder what every newspaper and blog this side of the Nativity will make of that. So, checkmate.
Well done, Reverend Talent. You're a natural at this game.
That's why I don't play.
What do you mean?
To come out of Empire, you have to refuse to use its tools, including blackmail.
You're a fool. You have me in one move, and then what? You decide to throw the game.
I don't throw the game. I simply refuse to play it.
You know I can have you arrested.
You have no choice. You're a victim of the system. I'm finally free of it.
A good friend of mine says the surest way to find your inner truth is through silence. Arrest me if you must, but... I should tell you, my daughter Jo, she's extremely talented, as you know. But I don't think she's ready to come out of Empire. Know what I mean? She's
far too busy quoting a very talented bard.
They that wait upon the Lord shall receive good reward. They shall mount up with wings like an eagle. We'll soar on through the sky. Just keep a watchful eye. Just watch and you will see. Watch the enemy flee, watch them set men free, watch God take the victory, watch. Gideon's army went out, and without a doubt, they did what the Father told them to do. Sword. That's what happens when you obey the Lord. Just watch and you will see. Watch the enemy flee. Watch him set men free. Watch God take the victory. Watch. They that wait upon the Lord shall receive good reward. They shall mount up with wings like an eagle. We'll soar on through the sky. Just keep that watchful.